Again, Ambassador G. Grachon.
Good evening, Anne-Lorraine.
Good evening, sir.
The question is, how has joining Binibining Pilipinas changed you?
Joining Binibining Pilipinas changed me a lot, and it cleared my advocacy in life, which is education, and my main purpose why I joined Binibining Pilipinas. For I believe that education can change the world. Thank you.
Congresswoman Lenny Robredo.
Good evening.
Good evening, ma'am.
I guess no beauty contest is complete without me asking this question. As a modern Filipina, what is more important? A successful career or a happy home?
For me, as a Filipina, we can have both. Because we are Filipina as very strong. We can face a lot of challenges. And we do not let challenges to stop us from reaching our goals in life. And we can, and to have that, like me, I want to pursue my education. And I want to have a better life, my family. And for us to have a happy family also. Thank you.
Mr. Bern Schneider.
Hello, Eliza.
Hello, good evening, sir.
Tell us, please, when is a woman truly successful?
A woman is truly successful when she sees the happiness of the people around her. And that she has a special person that she could stand right next to him, making him a stronger man that he can be. Thank you.
Short and sweet. Vice.
The beautiful. Ganda.
Okay, candidate number 23, this is her question. Aside from winning the crown tonight, what was your prayer when you woke up this morning?
Good evening, everyone. Besides winning the crown, this morning I prayed that my family would get here safely because my family traveled all the way here to watch me tonight, to stand on this stage, to be confident, strong, and hopefully beg an international crown. And I pray that they would get here safely because they mean the world to me, and they are my root, they are my ground, and they keep me strong and support me in whatever I do. Thank you.
Oh,
Justice.
Our chairman again.
Secretary Lila De Lima.
Hi there. Number 19, Christy from Nabwa, Camarines Sur.
Good evening.
Yes. What would you tell a child who longs for her OFW mother?
Something that I would tell a child who longs for their OFW mother is that whatever she is doing overseas is for the benefit of their own good, that she loves them very, very, very much, and she sacrificed a lot for her, him or her, and one day, she will be in their arms again, and everything will be all right.
My question for you is, March is International Women's Month. What do you believe is God's greatest gift to women?
God's greatest gift to women is actually, for me, bearing a child. Because I think giving birth to a kid is such a wonderful thing. Giving birth to life is such a wonderful thing. You can share your love, and you can raise a child to be something wonderful. Thank you.
Good evening, Kylie.
Good evening.
My question is, in our modern age, do you think it is appropriate for women to court men? Why or why not?
In our modern age today, I believe that anything is possible. That I believe that women who are strong, confident, and are empowered are allowed to do anything that they want. But personally, I believe that fidelity is still present and that men should be able to go after the women. And this is what I believe in. Thank you.